immigration now has improved?
In many ways, yes, and in a lot of ways, there's a lot of similarities to the way immigrants come to this country now as when he came here. Oftentimes, they came on the word or advice of friends or family that were already here, just as he did. They often came to the same towns, which is how he came here. And they supported each other once they arrived, and I think a lot of immigrants, even today, follow that same pattern.
Did he leave any family members behind?
Yes, many. Actually, the only members of his immediate generation that came here was his older brother, Antonio, and himself. Antonio would later return to Italy and remain there and start his own family. So of his seven brothers and sisters, he was the only one that remained in America. His parents also stayed in Italy.
Do you know if he brought, like, any valuables to the U.S.?
He didn't have very much to bring with him. From all accounts that I've been able to find, he arrived in Boston with $10.
Is there anything else you would like to say?
Well, there's lots of things I can say. You know, I think as the great-grandson of an immigrant and an American, there's a lot of things that we forget about our immigrant past. A lot of people don't remember that they're actually the grandchildren or children of immigrants, and that their parents or grandparents or great-grandparents went through very difficult times to come here and to start a new life. I think it's unfortunate that a lot of Americans, drawing back to what Diane had said earlier, that they don't appreciate the new immigrants that come to America, mostly because they forget what their own family members had gone through to come here, and I think that's unfortunate.
Later on in the 20th century, Latin Americans and Asians started to become the most popular immigration groups.
Thank you. Now back to you.
How did he feel about leaving his country and coming to the U.S.?
He didn't really have much left in his country. His home was taken over by other people who hated Jewish people, and so he didn't have a home. His parents had been killed, and also his other relatives had been killed, so he didn't know what to do, and he was just 17, and he had to figure out where to go. So he ended up traveling in Europe before he came here.
Was it difficult to live in a new country?
It was extremely difficult, especially for my parents. When we came here, my parents and I did not speak a word of English, not a word. Now, my parents put me in school. I was about 4 years old, and they sent me, I guess, to preschool. But for them, there were no free schools to learn English. They could not afford to pay money to learn English. So I'm not sure how they learned, but they did, whether it was listening to the radio or watching television. After a while, I helped translate for them, but they did eventually learn. It took a long time, but they did learn. And of course, it's also very difficult to learn a new culture. America is different from Europe. Things are done differently, and they had to learn that.
Did you know more than 3,000 people received visas before World War II?
Why did you pick USA over any other country?
Well, things were getting a bit tough in the islands in those days. It was really rough. And when you have five children to take care of, it's no picnic, because we didn't have that many jobs. Although we have oil, plenty oil there. But jobs were really scarce because they didn't have, at that time, too many merchants with big time stores to supply jobs with everybody. So that's why I migrated here. I'll be honest with you, my wife pushed me a lot to migrate. She says things are getting tough, so let's go overseas to the States, and that's what I did.
Hi, my name is Melina. I'm here with Gigi. So Gigi, what is the name of the famous person you did it with?
Mary Anton.
And where did your person come or how did they come to the U.S.?
She came from Russia.
What are three key facts that you learned about your poor?
Mary Anton, she came when she was only 13 years old. Then 2 years later, she had a poem published in the Boston Herald, and she became a famous writer.
And why did you choose to do this person?
Because I thought that since she was a writer, she would be very interesting.
Thank you. Back to you.
Do you enjoy it here in the USA?
Sure. Now I'm an American citizen. I enjoy it. The American dream is right here for everybody.
Knowing what you know now about the USA, would you still have moved here?
Sure. I think the USA is the number one country where everybody in the whole world would want to come to this country for freedom and equality, social justice, and education and the American dream. Here you can make it. Here you can do whatever you want. If you study, if you can work hard, you can make it here in this country. And this is the land of opportunity for all. And I like the USA because the USA is a land for everybody. And everybody who lives in the USA, they come from somewhere else. Everybody who lives here, they come from somewhere else. And this is a melting pot here.
Is there anything else you would like to say?
Well, first of all, I thank Prince Charles, my cousin, and he's a very nice young man. And I known him since he was a little boy. And he always, him and his father, always try to help kids. I thank him personally, and I thank you, and I thank all the other helpers. I'm sorry, I don't know your names, but I thank you, and I want to say that you guys are doing a good job, and thank you for having me as a guest. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
You're welcome. Bye.
Did you know that most immigrants that have taken refuge in America have been persecuted for their religious beliefs?
Did you know that more than 40% of all Americans can trace their roots back to Ellis Island?
Did you know in steerage class, ships can carry more than 1,000 immigrants?
What does immigration mean to you?
Well, to me, immigrants are so important to the United States. We, of course, are a country of immigrants. But when you think about anyone who's willing to leave everything behind, everything that they know, their friends, their families, and start over in a new country, those people are very, very special. They're willing to take chances. They're very resilient. They're strong. And this country needs immigrants. Immigrants start businesses, they create jobs, they're good workers, they buy things. They're very, very important for the economy. And of course, their culture is wonderful. We get different foods and music and clothes. So I think immigrants are especially important to America.
Is there anything else you'd like to say?
I would like to thank all of you for doing this project because I think it's very, very important at this time. Unfortunately, in this country, there is much anti-immigrant rhetoric and sentiment, and so much of it is based on misinformation. And I think doing a project like this helps to educate people about immigrants and how important they are to this country. And they find out that immigrants are like all of us. We all have the same hopes and dreams. We all want the same things. So thank you very much for doing this project.
Thank you for coming, Diane. Yeah. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber. majesties above the fruited plain. Oh, America, America, God shed His grace on thee. Country loved and mercy.